be honest, honest answer. So I'll give you that one. By front of the crowd.
When you get going like you did and you feel the crowd and you're coming off a tough loss on Newell Street, what did it take to have an effort like that and the team collectively get to rally behind that and play a game like this?
I mean, we knew we needed to get back on track, go out and compete. Sun came up today, you know, it's going to come up tomorrow regardless whether we win or lose. Same thing's going to happen Sunday or Monday, so. So we needed to play, it was going to happen. Game was happening regardless, we just needed to be perfect.
Joey, since you're sitting here, you're basically saying that you weren't even more excited than you were to have a I mean, I don't know if you noticed that, but are you noticing that you think you've already been through or not necessarily that you even close after you've been going?
Yeah, I mean, I feel confident in the ball and that's on the block and it's something I've spent my whole life playing, you know, with my back to the basket, playing confident. You know, and they're defensive. Didn't have a whole lot to show on film for them, so they probably weren't wrong and not having a whole lot, so.
And DJ, obviously everybody knows with you and Alec how you're going to bring this team every day, but Joey's doing what he's doing, and Alec, I mean, I'm sorry, not Alec, but Jamari's 4-3 is the first half. How does that help you two? How you guys can basically make life easier for you two?
Of course, but I mean, I'm just happy to see everybody playing with confidence. Jamari's shooting it, not hesitating. Joey getting the ball in the post and doing what he does best. And, I just feel like everybody was playing with confidence today, and that was awesome to see.
DJ, does Joey give you guys buckets like that in practice, or what? Have you seen that before?
He doesn't give me buckets like that, but Sam for sure. Sam, Kyle, everybody else, yeah. I'm joking, but I can't let him catch it, but he will shoot a hook shot, so.
Joey, knowing that Zed and Kyle both couldn't play, I guess, like, when did you get the word that you were going to start, and just how did you maybe try to frame your mind coming into this game knowing they were going to play you more minutes than you played in a while?
I mean, yesterday I was moved to Team 1, but I mean, nothing. So it wasn't like a, hey, you're starting. It wasn't like we sat down in a conference room and they broke the news to me. but I just wanted to be prepared for whatever opportunity happened, and that's why you stay ready and do the extra stuff so if an opportunity comes, you're prepared for it.
Joey, on Tuesday, Hunter Dickinson pretty much torched Michigan State. Did you look at the film and see, like, hey, I can kind of do stuff like this with my footwork? I kind of have a similar frame. I can kind of pull stuff off.
I mean, we watched some other film, but it wasn't as much of, hey, I want to. I just wanted to play my game and do what I felt confident doing in the flow of the game. But we saw the film, but it wasn't like, hey, I'm going to do this X, Y, Z. It was just whatever the flow of the game provided.
Joey, we were talking with Tom Izzo, and he mentioned that he thought the fans gave you a lift. Being that this is your first year at Ohio State, how did you feel the Buckeye Nuthouse and the rest of the fans in the shot supported you tonight?
It was great. It was great. I mean, since I've been 15 or 16 years old, I've always kind of been a spaz and played with emotion. I've just kind of been who I am. I don't, you know, that wouldn't take a whole lot of looking up to see me yelling and all that. So, yeah, I mean, I definitely play with passion. I feed off the crowd, and that's just part of me.
And then EJ Tom also mentioned that it wasn't the end that beat us, it was the start. Just what was clicking there at the start of the game to get out to such a big lead and make all five of the first shots?
I just felt like we had a lot of energy today. I feel like we played together. My coach was telling us, trust the pass, making one more passes, hitting the opening guy, just being confident in yourself and shooting the ball. And we were open, we were just knocking them down, just playing hard, getting to our spots.
Hey, Joey. Looks like you went from Southport to Portland to Butler to Indiana. How does playing for Ohio State and playing for a coach that used to coach your former team and also playing against the gentleman sitting next to you over here, Lisa Liddell, how does that build your confidence tonight? Which obviously everybody's talking about you, what you do is outstanding, but how are you able to compose yourself and focus on what needs to be done tonight?
I mean, there's, I think the nice part about, you know, playing with the guys here, playing for coaching staff, is there's a familiarity there of, like, you know, playing against them, knowing them, and all that. So there's a familiarity, which just kind of makes the transition easier. But, I mean, throughout the game, it was like, hey, the job's not finished. And, the goal is to win the game, and it really doesn't matter whatever EJ or I score. We're just trying to win. So whatever it is, to wrap up that.
So, Joey, until tonight, how had the reality of this year matched your expectation of how you'd be used in the minutes you get this year? Because you had 1 year left. You could have gone anywhere. I'm sure you evaluated a lot of places. I'm sure coaches' relationship with you out of high school entered into you coming here. But how did the reality of tonight match to the expectation?
Yeah, I mean, the reality was I wanted to play on a team that was going to win, contend for a Big Ten championship. You know, that those goals are still out there for us. So I mean, yeah, that's just kind of part of it. You know, there's basketball, there's, you know, ups and downs that are with it, but you're not allowed to, your emotion never trumps winning. The other day, winning is number one priority. Winning, everything else takes a backseat. So want to stay ready and be prepared for whatever opportunity came, and enjoy this last year, regardless of whatever that looks like.
Hey, we got one over here on the right.
So, Joey, we had a whole bunch of guys on the move today. What was going through your mind when you got the ball in the post?
Go to work. That was kind of the main thought of what I caught it was, go to work.
Is that, so. Joey, do you have a favorite post move, and do you have a special name for any of your post moves?
No, I don't really have a name for anything. I don't like shoot my left hand hook, my right hand hook, whatever is there.
What was your favorite moment of the game tonight? Was it the dunk at the end there, and how did you feel when that happened?
My favorite moment was when the clock ran out. We were celebrating as a team. That was my favorite.
He's lying. He was definitely good. Malachi's was probably my favorite moment. Joey's was close.
I don't think I've had any game dunk in over probably 2 years, so it's been a little while since that's happened.
EJ, you guys were tired, it looked like, the other night. Two straight losses. You started that game well. To come out, start this game well, but to sustain it, what did that take effort-wise, given the schedule that you guys were in?
I just felt like we played. I've been saying this a lot, but I just feel like we played with confidence, honestly. Joey made a great point. After our last game, we had a sat down and talked. Everybody just gave out their thoughts, and Joey was like, it's not like the season's over. We still have a lot to play for. Something's going to come up tomorrow, so we just had to leave that in the past and just learn from that, those two games. And we came out here and played with a lot of energy today, played very connected. Guys on the bench were very involved, and that's why we came out here and competed. So.
EJ, connectedness was something that your coach was mentioning after the Nebraska game, and I'm wondering, over the course of the last 48 hours, what does that look like in terms of, you know, creating an atmosphere or creating an offense that's connected as opposed to what you guys did, I guess, 48 hours ago?
I mean, all that stuff happens off the court. I mean, I trust everybody who's on the court at that time. And if a guy comes in off the bench, I mean, everybody has those big moments like Joey came in today. I trust him because I see the works he put in after practice, before practice. Just having confidence in each other when it comes to off the court, trusting them, knowing they're doing the right thing, and putting the work in to be good. So.
And I mean, we know Jamari as kind of a guy that, you know, has the ability to step up offensively, and as a guy who's kind of known for his defense, came in known as for his defense. But what did he bring? I mean, tonight it seemed like the four of you, whether it was you guys, Malachi and Jamari, kind of were this team tonight, and you guys kind of led together. What did he show?
He shot the ball. And I'm just happy he shot the ball, didn't hesitate, and just stepped into it and shot it. I feel like when he hesitates and thinks about it and doubts himself a little bit, it's not going to go in. But when he just steps up and shoots the ball, I think he's good most of the time, besides the one air ball he shot. Yeah.
All right, thank you guys.